This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF Channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. What is probably a good idea in some cases is to build a configuration file which is going to be utilized globally throughout the application. And by configuring or creating this type of file, it also makes it quicker and easy for you to configure your application. In some scenarios, it can be useful to create an application-specific configuration file, which will store or hold some of the more static variables or configuration options for your application. So in this scenario, we're going to be building inside of the SRC folder. Let's create a new file called config.ts. And inside of here, we're going to just add the default base URL and the default media URL. So the media URL in this case is going to be where the images are going to be served from for our application, at least for now. And then the base URL is going to be for the API. So we're going to export the base URL. So that's going to be http://, and then the Django DRF address, 0.1:8000, and then our API resides at /API. So whenever we create any requests, we can utilize this base URL. And of course, by having it in this file, it makes it so it's easy for us to change this. Should we move to the environment, a different environment, for example, if we start to move towards deploying the application. And of course, the media URL. So that's where we're going to find the images that we're going to be utilizing in this project while in development. So that's going to be .0.1:8000. It's like I never used a keyboard before. Right, there we go. So that's that in place. So we'll be able to access that throughout our project. Okay, so to summarize, there is two approaches here in actual fact. This is just one approach where we're exporting the configuration. But generally, the configuration file is commonly used to store various settings and parameters that can be accessed and utilized by different parts of our application. There are many different benefits, as you might be able to name a few yourself. So for example, centralized management of these different settings here, it's flexible and scalable. We can easily change and add to this. It means that potentially we can add any sensitive information in one place and secure it slightly differently. We've got code reusability that comes into this, and environment specific configurations, of course. So we could specify different configurations for different environments. Ultimately, this was an example to introduce you into the idea of creating a configuration file.